Hey there, hi there, hello there.
We are glad you are with us. This month, we are talking about how we can help our friends. But first, let's sing together.
Hey.
Hey.
Hi.
Hi.
Hello.
Hello. Hey, hi, hello.
God gives me friends, and I can pray for them. Help them out and cheer them on. They can learn from me, and I can learn from them. This is why God gives us friends.
God gives me friends. We can do life together. Friends. Life is so much better with friends. Showing God's love to them. This is why God gives us friends.
Them. I can help them out and cheer them on. They can learn from me, and I can learn from them. This is why God gives us friends.
God gives me friends. We can do life together. Friends. Life is so much better with friends. Showing God's love to them. This is why God gives us friends.
Consider others as more important than yourselves.
God gives me friends. We can do life together.
John 13, verses 1 through 20, we learn about how Jesus washed the feet of his disciples. Wait, just one minute. Someone washing somebody else's feet? Oh, that seems so yucky.
Well, people in Bible times had very dusty, dirty feet because they walked in the desert. You know what makes it even worse? He washed their feet the same night he would be betrayed. Let's watch our video to see what betray means.
Oh, hi there. Welcome to the clubhouse. My name is Mia.
I'm Lily.
And I'm Ezra, and we are
the Super Crew!
And this is our lovable friend, Bark. Say hi, Bark! We are all getting ready to go for a walk with Bark. Are you ready to go?
I'm ready. I love my red shoes. What about you, Ezra? Oh, Ezra, are you okay?
Well, it looks like I'm having trouble remembering how to tie my shoes. Do you loop-de-loop first? Or maybe it was the bunny ears? Ugh. Can you help me, Mia?
Of course, Ezra. I love helping my friends. When I can't remember how to tie my shoes, I say this rhyme to remember. Tying your shoes is fun to do. First, make bunny ears. One and two. Crisscross them over and pull them tight. Now, make a bow so they stay tied right. Yay! Your shoes are tied today.
Awesome! Thank you so much, Mia. You're a great friend.
Did you hear that? It sounded like the Super Box. Let's go see. Did you send us something super?
Yes!
Here at the clubhouse, we help connect the Super Clue, the Big Deal, and the Bible. Today's big deal is, hey, hi, hello, God gives me friends. Let's see what's inside.
Oh, I know what it is. It's a broom. Whenever my mom is cleaning, I can use a broom to help sweep the floor.
So, I wonder, what does a broom have to do with, hey, hi, hello, God gives me friends? Can you wonder with us?
Oh, I got it. A broom is something we use to help clean up. And God wants us to help our friends, like when we help our friends clean up. Or even like how Mia helped me tie my shoes.
You're right. Now, be looking, because you are going to see the super clue again. When you see the super clue, here's what I want you to do. Since our super clue is a broom, I want you to pretend to hold a broom and help sweep the floor. Like this. Can you try it with me? See the super clue? Help sweep. Good job.
I know how we can learn more about helping our friends. Let's
look in the Bible.
Remember, the Bible is God's book.
The Bible is true, and it's for you.
Today's Bible story comes from the book of John. Can you say John?
John.
In today's Bible story, Jesus and his friends were sitting down for a special meal called Passover. Jesus did something special to teach his friends something very important. Are you ready for today's Bible story?
Jesus washed his friends' feet. Jesus knew he was about to go back to heaven. Jesus loved his friends, the disciples, very much. He brought his 12 disciples together to share a special meal called Passover. Jesus got up from the table, took off his coat, and wrapped the towel around his waist. Then he poured water into a large bowl. One by one, Jesus washed each of his friends' feet in the water and dried their feet with a towel. When Jesus came to Peter, Peter asked, "Are you going to wash my feet too?" Jesus said, "Yes, Peter, I am going to wash your feet." "No," said Peter, "you will never wash my feet." Jesus answered, "Yes, Peter, I will wash your feet." When Jesus finished washing his friends' feet, he put his coat back on and sat down with them. "Do you know what I have done for you?" Jesus asked. "You call me teacher and Lord, and you are right, because that is what I am. So if I have washed your feet, you should wash one another's feet. I have given you an example to follow. Do what I do. Serve and help one another." Jesus taught his friends that they should love and serve others, just as Jesus had loved and served them.
Amazing! Jesus loved his friends so much that he taught them how important it was to serve and help them. Jesus could have made them wash his feet, but Jesus wanted to show his friends what it meant to help others. We can help and serve our friends just like Jesus did.
Oh, did you see something? It's our super clue. Do you remember what to do? Great job. A broom is something we can use to help our friends clean up. And Jesus taught his friends that they can help and serve one another too. So,
have learned that God gives us friends and we can help them. Jesus taught his friends how to serve by washing their feet. Jesus wants us to help and serve our friends too.
Jesus chose to serve his friends by washing their feet. Our Bible story shows us that we can help our friends like Jesus helped his friends.
That is a big deal. Let's say our big deal together. I'll say it first and then you say it after me. Hey, hi, hello.
Hey, hi, hello.
God gives me friends.
God gives me friends.
Great job.
God gives us friends, and we can help and serve our friends. We can show how much we love our friends by serving them.
Well, it looks like Bark is ready for our walk.
Say bye, Bark.
Bye!
Hey, friends. Let's learn a verse from the Bible that tells us how to treat our friends. Remember, the Bible is God's book. The Bible is true, and it's for you. Now listen and watch it first as we learn it together. Consider others as more important than yourselves. Philippians 2:3b. I want everyone to stand up so we can say the Bible verse. I'll say it first, then you can repeat it after me. Consider others.
Consider others.
As more important.
As more important.
Than yourselves.
Than yourselves.
Philippians 2, 3b.
Philippians 2, 3b.
This verse tells us that we should consider others. Consider means to think about other people. We can follow God by choosing to put other friends first. That means we can think of other people and help others when they need it. Let's say the verse again as you repeat it after me. Consider others.
Consider others.
As more important.
As more important.
Than yourselves.
Than yourselves.
Philippians 2, 3b.
Philippians 2, 3b.
Great job. When we consider or think of others the same way we think of ourselves, we are showing them how much they matter. God has put so many people in our lives. When we consider them first, we can cheer them on, help them, or even learn from them. We can show them how great they are. Let's say it one more time, all together, but this time loudly with our cheering voices. Ready? One, two, three.
Consider others as more important than yourselves.
Philippians 2, 3b.
God gives us friends. We can show them how much they matter by the way we treat them. See you next time.
Jesus really did surprise his disciples by doing such a lowly job. But in doing so, he was teaching them how we're to love and serve each other. Let's pray and ask God to help us love and serve each other. God, sometimes it's easy to do things for other people, and sometimes it isn't. We pray that you would help us to think about others the way you did, to love them, and to even be willing to do things that might be difficult. We pray that you would give us strength to help others and to love others and to serve them the way you would. And everybody said,
Amen. Amen. See you later.
Bye.